Hello, welcome to this video for the Jaguar. As you can see, it's the 4.2. I've decided to start with a bonnet on this one, so it's not fiddly for me, as you can hear. Very nice sounding engine, very smooth. Air brake suspension, as you can see. A lot of aluminium under this bonnet. And obviously the bonnet opens forward. Okay, around the other side. It's just been serviced by the Jaguar Specialist of Sheffield, or Sheffield Prestige, which is also a Land Rover dealer. So Land Rover Jaguar Specialist service. Okay, just close that bonnet now. I think it's a fiberglass bonnet, that, or aluminium? Aluminium bonnets. A lot of aluminium. Right, the boot. As you can see, it's carpeted up here. Carpet parcel shelf as well. All this is carpeted. It has got a spare wheel. It's a Space Saver Slimline one. There we go. It's all dry down here as well. Okay. Nice and clean here, no scratches on the bumper. Let's pull that back down. It's inside the car. As you can see, it's got this beautiful cream door card, leather and carpeted, as you can see. Very clean. It's got this like carbon silver garnish. Three memory setting electric seat with lumbar support as well. As you can see, little tweeters up here. Speaker grill's in nice condition, no cracks. All the door shuts are nice and clean. No grease or dirt in there. The sills are very clean as well. Jaguar brush aluminium effect stainless steel plate there. A little tiny bit of wear on the rubber there, as you can see. Just a little bit where the feet have gone in and out. 121,000 miles, that is acceptable. The seat, very good condition, as you can see, very good condition, absolutely no wear at all for the mileage, which is fantastic. Okay, let's get in the bike, pull that forward, obviously, and then move it with the electric seat. Just move that forward, like so. Okay, the bike, obviously this is called a 2+2, it's for children, adults will not get much. Well, you might be able to get some feet there. You have to be very sure. Okay, so you've got this lovely black carpet as well here, which is totally unmarked. Backs of the seats are very good as well. You've got the side airbags, as you can see. Move that forward back again so I can get in. It's got the Jaguar front car mat set. As you can see down there, the pedals are nice and clean. What else have you got? You've got all this, the boot release button there as well. The steering wheel. Armrest is nice and clean. Just get inside this vehicle now. Okay. It's got two keys as well. Two keys. Got the Jaguar head unit. The climate control. Stop start button, gear lever, traction control, handbrake, heated seats is on the computer. Then you've got the voice command. So there we've got the, what we're saying, one of the smart key batteries as well. So I've got two keys here. So I've got two keys here, as you can see. Oop. One of the batteries is low, and then you've got the auto lights there as well. Cruise control, volume and track and voice command as well. Electric, all right, we've been through that. You've got the alarm sensors up there. Your heated seats is on the computer there. And you've got this gorgeous carbon effect vinyl not vinyl, it's a laminate, should we say. Electric passenger seat, a lockable glove box, all the service history documents are there. In fact, let's go through those while we're here. Service portfolio. So you've got the service booklet here for this one here, for the Jag. As you can see, early on its life there, it's got the 8,000 mile start, and then it went to the 1927. What's that say? Hang on. That 27, 37, and then you've got the, hang on, 49, 60. Then you've got another one at 73, and then you've got 92 Jaguar. So 92, 861 Jaguar stopped. Then there's one here, Formula One Auto Centres at 103. And then this one is at Andrew Bradbury, 112. Andrew Bradbury again at 114. So just 2,000 miles, that one. And then 5,000 miles later, Autobahn, which sounds like a German specialist, Newcastle on the line. And this is the one that we've just had done, Sheffield Prestige, which is a Land Rover and Jaguar specialist. It was 15th of the 2nd at 121,000 miles. So we've got a massive, how many services? 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 13 services. Okay, so we've also got invoices, some invoices along the way, old MOTs, new MOTs. Hang on, what's this MOT? MOT here, 13th of the 2nd, 2023. No advisories on that, as you've seen, with all the tyres are good, all the brake pads are good. It's all the previous MOT certificates, which are online anyway, so there's no reason why these need to be seen, but they're all there, back into the old ones as well. Some tracking receipt there with some tyres from Formula One Auto Centres, that's the oil, etc. So that's all there. Another one, specialist oil. Tires, and then we've got, what's this one, Sheffield Prestige. This is the service here as well, the oil service there, the Sheffield Prestige, which is the Jaguar specialist. The logbook here, which it says, if you can see, so it's Jaguar, it's the XK Auto, 4196cc. This is the old private plate, this one. So that was a private plate before. Right, okay, so let's go to the rev the engine. Oh, there's two keys here, by the way. There's two keys there, the keyless ones. There's a USB and iPod input port there. That's the pod for the, was that for the key? I think that's for the key. One of the keys sitting there. Yeah. So that's key that it goes in there, and then let's rev the engine. It's beautiful, that. Let's go outside the car and rev it with the so you can hear it. Tapping noises, etc. Actually got another one just arrived over there, you can see as well, a black one. That's, that black one's ready to go to the Jaguar specialist as well. So there we have it, very nice 4.2 normally aspirated engine. So these are the supercharger air vents, which obviously have been fitted. As you can see, it's got the XKR body styling, should we say. It is in very good condition. However, there are some very slight age-rated faults starting to show through. Like on this bottom here, you've got a little bit of the movement on the body kit there, which probably could do with looking at a further date. It's solid, it's not moving around, but it's just a little bit, it's come away a little tiny bit. I don't know if it's the heat or the age. So we've got little things like that to look at. A couple of little stone chips on the that edge there. That's all. Other than that, it's all right. It's good. I mean, it's 14 years old. 14 years old. So, you know, I'm going to point this out to you as well. See that there, right on the corner of the light there at the bottom. Got a little tiny crack there. A little tiny crack, but it's right in the corner. What do you do? It doesn't validate changing a complete new head light unit in our view at 14 years old. It's a lot of, it's a real Eiffel car. We like to be good and honest with people. Don't want you driving 200 miles to us and then, you know, coming down here and saying, oh look, I can see that's moved a little bit, I'm not happy with that, knock me £1,000 off. No, we're not like that. We show you. It's what you'd expect for a 121,000 mile car. We have got a few cars in the showroom that have done 18,000 miles. We've got a 9,000 mile SVR, which is 18 months old. That's £100,000. So, you know, a 14 year old car with 121,000 mile in this condition is very good. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. We can arrange finance on this vehicle. Oh, yes we can. It'll be a short term because it's 14 years old and the finance companies only like financing vehicles up to 15 years old. So they may put a 24 or 36 month finance deal on this one. So yeah, okay, thank you for watching and hope to see you soon.